Hello, I'm Richard Raffan. In this video, I'm aiming to turn this square blank into a square kind of chunky dish. I was given this block of wood and it's been cut down from a larger blank, a larger disc. There was a big split somewhere, I can't remember the defects now, but the centre used to be there. The centre is now there. You can just possibly see where I was going to cut it out as a circle. As it is, it's now just going onto the screw chuck using this. Hole more or less at right angles. We'll go onto the screw, okay. And I don't need all that much screw, so I'll reduce that length with a MDF disc. In fact, I might even have a thicker one than that. Yeah. I don't throw this on as I might normally. Right, and the main things to see, I've got this load of kind of knot hole there which might need to be filled later. It might be connected with that, and I've got a knot up there and who knows what that might do. Anyway, first thing always with these is to get the bottom smooth with that and then just take the corners off. And for that, as usual, I'm going to be using a half inch spindle gouge. When I'm making these cuts, I really don't have much idea of what the shape is, so I'm watching it up on the top horizon. I'm not after absolutely square here, I want, as you'll see later, but I am thinking in terms of a wall thickness, if you like, a thickness of about half an inch. It might come down a bit thinner, but I'd really quite like to have a go at one of the chunky ones. Now I need to get all this rough stuff off, and I can see there's some fiddleback coming through, which is nice, which I've forgotten about. Right, just using the wing of the tool, just pulling it back. All I'm after at this stage is a flat surface here, which I still haven't got, so I can then take a shear cut back to the middle. Move the rest a bit closer. Right. If you're wondering why I haven't put the rest in that position for doing this cut, it's just more convenient with the rest at an angle here because your hands are out of the way and can just move the tool forwards, whereas if my hand is here, it's just awkward. So when I'm doing the bottom, I tend to have the rest at a slight angle. And I'm going to be hiding behind the rest too with those corners coming round. Still a bit to come there, but that'll probably come off because I'm now thinking in terms of where the foot's going to be. It's somewhere in around there, and I've got a couple of choices for chucks, and I'm going to be using this, I think it's 125 millimeter, which is about 5 inches, and that will do me quite nicely. So I have some dividers already set to that size. Next thing is to establish the diameter of the foot, then I can work in relation to that. So I need to get center, which is there, between the two points, but keep the right point clear. Just make a mark with the left so it lines up with the right. It's going to be about there. Maybe slightly in. So, lining the bevel up with the direction I want to go, which in this case is straight in, just pivot the tool into the wood. And then from there, right on its side and drag it back. So I want a steeper angle here, so now I'm going to use the 3/8 bowl gouge, asymmetric bowl gouge. It's got a very steep right wing, so short steep right wing, which means I've got a more comfortable start here with the bevel rubbing. I don't know how this wood's going to work, but it didn't look as though it'd be a problem. Situation, very important to take the tool on a smooth path so you don't have too many grooves to get rid of. Right, it's not cutting too badly. It's going to sand very well by the look of it, which is nice. Ah, I hadn't noticed that, which is goes down half the height of the of my foot, so that foot's going to have to go down a bit more, and then I think I'll take that off first and then take the foot down. So I'm going to use the scraper flat on the rest. Yeah. Right, that's gone. Now I can step this back. Moving the rest back so that I can raise the handle so that the tool is working at center rather than dropping the rest. That's just a bit easier. And it ensures the negative rake, which is between the angle between the wood I'm cutting and the top of the tool, needs to be less than 90 degrees. If it's sticking up and it has a catch, the tool's going to bang back, or if you're doing that kind of thing, you'll be hanging on to it and there'll be a big mark on the wood. So I want this to sit on its rim, so you make sure that's there's some daylight underneath the rule. And now I'm going to come in and use this tool this time. That foot definitely needs to be a bit bigger, so half inch spindle gouge again. Now the big problem here, I'm sure you can see, is going to be when you're up here, you're turning an awful lot of space. So it's very important the tool doesn't go hard, you don't push the tool hard against the surface. Up here there's a teeny little groove. I could sand this, but what I'm going to do is just shear scrape it. And the reason for that is, if I keep the tool flat on the rest, it's very difficult just to take a very little shaving. There's often quite a bit in contact with the tool. If I tilt it up on edge, there's comparatively little. And this is why this tool, it's a shear scraping tool, it's got a rounded side. So for this, my hands are going to be planted on the rest. I'm just going to squeeze the tool back and forth along the rest. And the dust is coming off near the bottom, just there. I'm going to have a bit more speed. At the moment, my curve is just flattening out a bit, so it's not a curve. So I'm going to just bring that in. That means when I come to square up this plate later, or do the edges, it's going to be slightly smaller than I was expecting. Or should we say hoping for. So that's looking pretty nice up there. The foot, I'm going to put a little corner on the shear scraper. And just ease that in. And that gives me a little bit of decoration with not much effort. And then the 3/8 spindle gouge comes in on its side on top of the foot. Rotate it very slightly clockwise, so there's a teeny kind of shear scrape. You can see where the dust is, I expect, and the shiny bit where it's actually cutting. And then I'm going to do the same with the other side, just use the wing of the tool just to stroke the surface. The rest of that will come off quite nicely with sanding anyway. And now I'm going to sand it, and the dust extraction goes on, so there will be noise. And when I come up the side, up where there's space, I'm going to have a sanding block, which is one of these. This is wood. I'll just start off with that one, and then maybe transfer to a rubber one if I need to, but this is probably will do the job. Well, that's working very nicely, sounding very nice and good. So that's the 180 grit. The blue 240 grit. Could do with a new bit. I've got to go and find it. So I'm back here with the 240 grit, comes in rolls, and because it's cloth backed, you can tear it easily. I think people don't seem to understand. So that's across, then tear that into length, so it's just under 100 mil wide, and then you fold it with the warp, and that way it stays folded. If you fold it the way it was rolled, then it tends not to stay folded. I'm looking at this and thinking this could do with being a bit steeper as a yes, I want to flatten that out a bit. It's just going to make for a different shaped dish. So, seems a pity when it's all going quite nicely, but it will look better in the long run, I hope. Right, I happened to pick up the half-inch spindle gouge, so it's got also got an asymmetric grind, fairly steep right wing. And what I'm trying to do is raise the level of this bit. That sounds a bit sharp up there, so I'll just take that off. Again, I'm watching what I'm doing over on the top horizon. Right, so my square, I'm sure it'll work out all right. It'll be easier if you see it rather than me trying to explain it. This is extremely sharp, so it's worth taking that off. Just me catching my finger. Right, back to the blue. Try the rubber block. Use a rotary sander as well. This is 240 grit. Thank you. That's good. And I'm going to oil this once it's off the lathe. So that comes off and goes into the chuck. First thing always with this is to flatten off the top, just slightly undulating, and then drill a depth hole. So that was the 3/8 bowl gouge, using the wing first, tool roll right over on its side to get that smooth. Right, that drill is a twist drill with a number of lines on it which I've ground on. If you make one of these, it's good to get a black drill so that you can see the marks. Much more difficult on a silver drill. So, it probably won't need to go in very far. There. Right, 1/2 inch spindle gouge. Now a lot of you will be thinking, oh, you should never use a spindle gouge on a bowl. When you hear about spindle gouges on bowls, what we're talking about is deep fluted spindle roughing gouges. A shallow gouge like this, spindle gouge, absolutely fine. Anything else is an even wall thickness down here, so that'll be about right, and once I get into the wood a bit, this is going to go away. Get the rim done first. I thought it would go away, but not yet. That's cutting very, very nicely, this wood. Might even make it a bit thinner. Yeah, a bit more. Dangerous to reach around this while it's running, so it's a little bit more out of it there. That's probably about the right thickness in there. Right, so it's a different shape to what I had in mind. Now, going across the bottom, I like to use a curve which is just inside the curve I'm trying to cut. That's just a bit straight. This is probably a bit steeper than I would use normally, but we'll use this one. Beginning to sound a bit thin. begin to sound very thin. A little bit worrying. I think I'm going to measure it. So these... The idea with these is you let the pressure off the ring here and just take it up until you feel some pressure, and that will give you the thickness, which is thin. So that's so I could hear that coming. Looks like this is going to be a thin dish. So you don't want to take much more out of that. Oops. So get the bottom done. Bit out of the side here. It feels like a small kind of lump there. Now the way to attack this is to drop the rest slightly and shear scrape. You don't want to bring the tool flat here. You need to tilt it up on edge and support the outside so you can see where the dust is coming off. Good. The other thing I need here is some marks just to know where the center of the square is, really. I might do that off the lathe. Right, so I'm going to do this, and I can hand sand that easily enough. Or I can use power sanding. Use some 120 grit this time. You don't want your fingers slipping into these sharp edges, so it pays if you get probably the sand with a block, with the rubber. Now, the next thing which is useful when I'm sanding it off is I need to know where the corners are. So I'm just going to put a little... Oh, there's a chip out there. It'll probably go anyway when I do the next bit. So I just want a little line up here. Just the moment, I'll also have a center. There's a little white dot in the middle. Now I'm just going to get a ruler going across the center so I can mark where the middle, where the corners are fairly accurately. They don't need to be dead accurate, I just need a little ruler which presses down into the middle, something flexible. Certainly isn't that one. So just line it across the middle. That'll be it. I don't want this to be dead square. I think at completely square dishes just look boring, very boring. That. Now, quickest way to do, or the easiest way to do this, is just to get a big sander and push it against it. And I think this wood is soft enough that I can do that. So now I have a sanding disc which goes on the screw chuck. Sand between these two points, holding the dish at an angle. And I want to come down to get rid of that mark. Bit of crepe rubber to clean the butt disc. I find these just sitting up a little bit too much. I'd rather have less of a peak. Right, just a little bit steeper than I was really after there, but that can go back on the lathe and I can sand that off, or I could do it by hand, and then that just needs oiling. Sander. Get a lock of spindle. Thank you. So, boiled linseed oil with a top any child would get off in milliseconds, and I can't. Ah, there we are. The nice illusion here is that you look at the top, it looks curved when in fact that plane is flat. So another useful little dish.